seem to have more balanced boards, just like Facebook, Amazon, Microsoft have two female encoders, whereas Google have three. Researchers find that diversity of thoughts leads to better problem solving. As if when we collaborate multiple minds, the people with different gender, sexual orientation and race in our workplace, we all doing better jobs. When researcher asked to the leaders, what help you to increase the effectiveness in the organization? Leader answered, organization need to start creating more transparency, more attention to promoting women in board role. This is the atmosphere in which everyone has a chance to be a leader. Creating an family environment which includes mentoring, training program and a lot more. Thanks, Drishti. Coming back to the elephant in the room, do you think Riddhi, women are still better than men?
Thank you,
Anjali.
According to me, yes, women are better practitioners in corporate governance because, you know, they work at the ground level. And one more point, that it is very necessary in a good governance that it should be linked to the CSR, that is corporate social responsibility. It is the responsibility of a company towards the whole society at large. So, including a woman in the board, she will help to identify the CSR activities in a company. Her compassionate and concerned and motherly touch will seek the responsibilities of the company. So as we all know that our mother, she knows what is wrong with us. So in respect of corporation, we can say that a woman in a corporation can seek that what is wrong and where the wrong is happening in the company, and then she could resolve that. So including a woman is very necessary, and we saw after our discussion that despite so many hurdles, so many obstacles and so many stereotypes, still the woman is growing and she is fighting with all the odds. So we can say that yes, she is the better practitioner. Here at last, I want to just tell a story of former Washington Post CEO Kathleen Graham. She was unaware of her abilities until the tragedy struck with her. So what happened was her husband died untimely due to the suicide depression. So she has to take over her husband's responsibility, and she worked as a post publisher. So this tragedy showed her a way that she could be better and she could perform very well and take the company to the heights. So this made her the woman who is she was the first female CEO of a Fortune 500 company. So in her autobiography, she has stated, what I essentially did was to put one foot in front of other and shut my eyes and step off the edge. This was the courage that led her to the first female Fortune 500 company. So just think, if the lady love could take a man to the success, then what a lady alone can do in a corporate world. Thank you.
Nicely said by Hillary Clinton, women are largest reservoirs of untapped talent of the world. On this note, I would like to end our discussion. Thanks for being such a patient. Now we are open to your questions if you have any queries.
That we have to prove ourselves that yes, we are better than men. It's just we want the same level. Like you said, there are several. Things in which women are lag behind, or they are not they are not brought up to that level. So it's just we need the same balance or the same ground. We are not on the edge to sort some competition or something like that.
Actually, we are not talking about how we not at the same level with the men. We are same level. Actually, we are not at the same level because we are not there to compete with them.
I just wanted to say that she said that women are better than men. It is only this night pinched me out that we are not in a verge to have a competition like in the opposite gender. We just want the same level. Where is this term
"better"
coming?
Actually, we women are better at some point with men. Actually, when we talk about the reading between the lines in an organization, what men can see is what with the naked eyes. But even we know that there is a sixth sense we say that which helps us to recognize or to know what are going on or what is going on inside, and we help it. There are things, although the fact that gender culture has been into such a big scam, but the time when ICIC was almost at the point of being bankrupt, she seen the three C's, which was the reason because of which the bank was about to bankrupt. The three C's were I still don't remember the exact C's, but that only because of these three C's, the bank was about to bankrupt. But Chanda Koche should let the bank in such a manner that these three C's became the new foundation of the bank. And this is what Chanda Koche, for she and not the other members of the bank, which were made. I'm like, okay with the answer, or I should say something else.
It's just I wanted to say that no deny to the fact that we women are with our sixth sense sort of the thing, or we can initiate things better than men. But it's just, I felt on my personal level on this conversation, that's my personal opinion, that we are not in a world or sort of competition with men around that we have to prove ourselves better or something like that. It's just we are on the same grounds, competing parallel,
but the society don't allow us. There are groups where we are not standing at the same front or foot with the men. There are companies where women are not allowed to go at the top levels. As she said, only the women of families are included in the factory so that they don't answer, so that they don't vote in the company. They have no opinion. That's why we are fighting for a better future at our company.